All right, guys. Y'all wanted Elvis? He's agreed.
Oh, no, I did not.
Ready?
No.
1, 2, 3, hit it. Come on.
Did you hear the crickets?
And the crickets. No, they didn't want the crickets. They wanted Elvis.
Yeah. I told you, I'm done saying it.
We're in the shop. Trying to find some lost tools. Oh, quit. No.
I ain't trying to find no tools. I'm just trying to find the lost one.
Biting.
He runs out.
Well, guys, we got a busy day ahead of us. We're going to show you what we're doing. All right, my YouTube friends. So as you might have surmised by now from the last few videos, I've got a side hustle. Everybody needs a side hustle. Mine is buying, cleaning, repairing, and selling vehicles. So this one, we just got back from the shop yesterday. You saw where we took it down, had the muffler fixed. And it is nice and quiet now. I'm not even sure if you can hear it running as compared to yesterday when we loaded it on the trailer and it sounded awful. At any rate, it is now time for a bath. Just bought this Meguiar's car wash and got the old car wash brush out. And we're gonna see if we can clean it up, get the dirt off of it, get ready to take some pictures and sell it. All right, tell them what your job description is officially.
Bring it to work.
So y'all might not know this, but we have an official job position here, and that is if something goes wrong, it's your fault. That's him. If anything breaks, ends up disappearing, I put it somewhere and can't remember where I put it, gets
but
lost,
if
broken.
Goes right, he done it.
Yeah, if it goes right, it's my fault. You can blame it on me. But he gets paid to be the scapegoat. That's why they make long-tailed t-shirts. All right, guys, now that it's washed and cleaned up, there's a few spots, like this scuff on the side of the door, that I want to get buffed out, shined up, made to look nice. I'm using this new finish Scratch Doctor, which I really like. It's what I carried with me when I was out on the road. Works really, really well. Put it on a little buffing head on a drill and go to town on that spot on the door. It should disappear.
30 seconds later,
I promise this is the same spot. Check it out. Now there is a teeny tiny little dent right there. You can see the shadow change right where the scuff mark was, and there's nothing I can do with that dent right now, but you see how nicely it cleaned up. When people are buying cars, they typically buy with their eyes first. Then they'll start looking at specifics on the car, unless they're looking for a specific type of car. They just want something that looks nice and is dependable. So when it comes to looking nice, scratches like these on the hood and the fender really detract on a close-up. As you can see from back here, it looks great. But when you're up here close walking around, you start seeing those little scratches, and that's when you can start Jewing somebody down. Probably shouldn't use that term. It's an old term. When you start trying to talk somebody down, say, look, it's all scratched up. I gotta take that and get it fixed. It's gonna cost me some money to have it buffed. So I'm just gonna go ahead and remove that concern. So when somebody walks up and looks at it, they're like, wow, that's a nice clean car. So let's see what we can do with this. Well, it looks much better. There's a couple of deeper scratches that I would have to do some wet sanding on to get them removed. Look at the difference. Much, much better. All right, here's our second project for the day. Another vehicle from Copart, where we used to haul them out of. See how nasty and dirty those wheels are. Some pretty decent little scuffs in the paint on the side. Not a bad looking old van. Got a few little dents and dings in it, but you know, for a cheap ride, it's tax season. All right, Scoob, what do you think? Can we get these scratches out? Okay, so as you can see, this is pretty nasty looking scratches in that door. I'm gonna see if this scratch doctor can do any good to it. We'll find out. Okay, as you can see, I've got a bunch of little dull spots. That's where I ended up having to dig out the 400 grit and then the 1000 grit wet sandpaper to get down through those scratches. I can run my thumb across it and catch even with my glove on. So y'all can even hear it. So I'm gonna have to sand that one out too, but I've got these sanded down. Now I'm gonna buff them out, see if we can get a nice glaze back.
Guys, it is starting to rain on us, but
that is after wet sanding, buffing, polishing. And as you can see, well, that's just a little hair. One little scratch I missed. But anyway, it's cleaned up quite nicely. Back here, all along the fender well with some red paint that had rubbed off. All these little water droplets are really standing out like damage, but that is a nice shine now on that fender.